There we go. So we were saying that Earl on the outside looks simple, but for me he's number two pound for pound after Canelo, because he has three belts. Every fight that he's had has been tough. There's no like gimmies. Right. And someone compared his resume.
Wait. How can you put Canelo in when? See, remember what? I think he's a phenomenal fighter. Think about this. Pound for pound is a hypothetical situation. So hypothetically, if he goes up that way, if he goes up this way, he finds a lightweight, he'll win. But he went up to a place where he couldn't win. So he can't be on the list because he is not a hypothetical anymore. He can't be the best. Do you see what I'm saying? Because I think when they say pound for pound is like, if he fought at heavyweight, fought a cruiserweight, fought a lightweight, fought 6'8", then he would be great. But he went up to 54, went up to 60, went up to 68. And he met his match at 74, right? 75. So that's like, you can't, that's the point where you can't be the best because you met the, I'm not saying he's not great because he'll beat anybody else. Maybe not better be him, but he beat anybody else, at all those other weights below him. But I think that it's more difficult. And I'm not going to say that because I know some guys in that weight. But I'm not going to say, but he's great and he's a great fighter. I'm not gonna say he'll beat all the other guys.
But you don't know if he's number one. But I'm saying for Earl being number one or number two, to me
put it like this. From a perspective of success, yes, right? But then you could the number one fighter in the world is still Anthony Joshua. Because he can pack it in and can sell it. Then it's Canelo, Earl, whatever. Then it's Tank Davis, right? Because those four guys are pay-per-view fighters. Like they pack like this weigh-in was crazy.
It was crazy. And it was close to fans and it was packed.
Listen. There was more people on the outside than more on the inside.
I know.
That's the truth. And it was close to fans. It was packed. Right.
And this wasn't announced to open or advertised. They could have done it at the venue.
Right.
Like Manny Pacquiao Wayne's where half of the venues open. And it would have been packed. But I would say Jermell Charlo is very close to the top five when it comes to popularity.
I'm going by money makers. And because Jermell is in the top five, but you know what I'm saying? But I'm not talking about like the skill set and the talent. I'm talking about from
marketing, selling.
That's what I'm talking about.
Pay per view. Tank, this is sixth pay per view. It takes time to get there.
That's what I'm talking about. Now, I'm not talking about skill set and Jermell's top.
But, Derrick, you know boxing, you follow boxing. How do you compare Crawford's last six opponents to Errol Spence's last six opponents?
I don't really know who he fought. So, because I don't like boxing, I have to know. I saw some people put some stuff on social media, but I really didn't look at it.
He fought at Venetian, Porter, Kell Brook, Amir Khan, and someone else.
I'm not going to get into that. I'm just going to say that it's not the same.
Obviously, what happened? Somebody getting into something? It's the first time in D.C., so did you go see any of the monuments yet?
Not yet. I'm going.
Tomorrow morning. It's a little cold outside.
Tomorrow morning, I'm getting up early and walking.
Call me. Let me go with you. I want to see some of the stuff, too. Yeah. I haven't been in years. So, Derrick, what's your message to all your fans? 2022 was a phenomenal year. You hope to continue the same thing in 2023?
Yeah, man, no doubt. I just hope to just stay focused and not be so high on my situation and stay humble, stay on the ground, and keep moving.
I think that's the key for anybody. Anybody that wins a title, you just won a title. Your journey's not done.
Well, it depends on what their dreams were. To win a title and to be champion for a while. I think sometimes winning a title is going to make you a champion. It's a consistency.
Yeah.
Sometimes people get lost in that.
It happens. Happens to fighters sometimes. They get so caught up in one win.
Right.
But you're right, consistency. So everybody, Derrick D. James won.
Derrick D. James won
on Instagram. And stay tuned. Please do report.com. We'll be back reporting.